In Silicon Valley, devices are an essential part of daily life. But many of the tech titans creating these products choose to power down when they leave the office, following industry giants like Bill Gates and Steve Jobs, who restricted their own kids' access to technology at home. Pierre Laurent has worked for companies including Microsoft and Intel.
The phones are typically set on a table at the entrance. That's where they live most of the time.
He says the tech industry designs products to hook users.
Do you think the average parent is aware of that danger?
No, I don't think the parents are aware of that. They don't see the consequences because nobody's told them. You know, there's no warning on the product.
Pierre and his wife Monica became concerned that their three children would miss out on real-life experiences while on their devices. So they decided to limit their screen time. Researchers are still learning more about how technology affects kids, but some early studies of heavy tech users show potential links to a rise in teen suicide rates, addiction, anxiety, and loss of social skills.
Do they ever come to you and say, I really just want a tablet, I want a cell phone, I want...
Oh, absolutely.
There was some pressure, especially the last one. She didn't want to miss out or something. And then, we said, no, it's not the right time.
None of the three children played video games or watched TV, and they didn't get cell phones until they were teenagers. Their 13-year-old daughter Maya spends her free time knitting and playing in the backyard.
Do you ever miss technology?
Not really, no. The only thing I might miss technology for is listening to music or an audiobook.
Their use of tech is limited both at home and at school.
12 divided by 4 is 3.
Here at the Waldorf School, where Monica is a teacher, nearly 75% of the kids have parents who work in tech. The school favors physical activity and art over technology. Computers are not introduced until 8th grade. Teachers use a hand clapping game to practice multiplication tables.
4, 5, 6.
Every parent is really struggling with how to reap the benefits of technology while minimizing some of the risks.
Caroline Knorr is the senior parenting editor for Common Sense Media, a nonprofit that studies the effect of media and technology on kids.
We do need to look at the technology itself and understand that there's a lot of stuff in there that is absolutely designed to change user behavior. And these programs are reaching kids at younger and younger ages.
The organization says there's no magic number on how much screen time kids should have and cautions that imposing limits ignores potential benefits. They recommend paying close attention to kids' demeanor while using their devices and creating a schedule with guidelines on the types of tech activities they can do and for how long. Even after getting a cell phone this year, Maya says she prefers to spend time baking and doing crafts.
I do stuff with my hands a lot, and I find it more fun to do that than to just watch stuff and go on social media.
Yeah, I'm putting the cake in the oven.
For Monica and Pierre, the hope is that a tech-free childhood will lead to more balance later in life.
I really believe that there is a time for technology. It's not a forbidden fruit. It should not be. But I think especially young children need to grow in a different environment that hasn't had that much technology in it.
For CBS This Morning, Jamie Yuccas, Silicon Valley.
Hooray for Monica and Pierre.
I think so, too. Mm-hmm. So, too. Too much tech, I don't think it's good for kids. You've got little kids. What do you think, Mom?
No, my kids were cooking with me last night, chopping tomatoes nice and small for salsa. Put down the phone.